Hello. Who are you? Doesn't matter. Welcome.
You're safe with me. I'll be right here, nice and close, so I can speak without alerting the others.
Let me tell you about Senua. Her story has already come to an end, but now it begins anew.
What's happening? It's breathing. Dead. It's breathing. It's breathing. He knows she's getting closer.
He can feel her coming closer.
She's getting
They're watching.
This is a journey deep into darkness. There'll be no more stories after this one.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this?
They're watching.
Why doesn't she come back? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
I can feel you coming.
Shh.
Quiet.
Oh, how rude of me. I never told you of the others. You hear them too, right? They've been around ever since the tragedy. That's not quite true. Some are old, some are new, but they've changed. I think the darkness changed them, just like it changed her.
Can you see them? Over there.
Why isn't she looking?
Why aren't you looking?
She's in Helheim.
Look. Up ahead. You see it too?
You promised you came here.
Yes. It is real after all. She's finally arrived in the land of mist and fog. The place the Northmen call Hell. Look around and you will see them. The drowned, the sick, the slain. Here they lie, rotting in the fields and rivers of Hell. But the dead don't always lie still here. This is not a place of rest.
Can't do this. Go back, go back.
They're going to do that to you. Can you see them? Can you see them? They're going to do that to you.
What is she thinking? I can tell you. She's afraid. Wouldn't you be? You'd think she would get used to it by now after so many years. But the darkness, it just builds onto itself, growing stronger, towering over her. You might try and ignore it. Turn away. But it's always there, just out of sight, where you're most vulnerable. It's like it knows that just enough light is all you need to see its suffocating power. You might think she's brave to go on this journey on her own, but it isn't bravery that drives her.
bravery only means something to those afraid of death. Senua's fear runs far, far deeper.
What is she looking at? What is she leaving behind?
I know what she's thinking. I hear her thoughts.
It's not too late to get into the boat and go back. No one will judge her. No one will ever know.
Oh, she heard us. There's no going back.
You can't do it.
Senua pushes away a world that conspired to cause so much suffering. There's nothing to go back to, and worse to look forward to. Why don't you join us? Maybe you too have a part to play in this story.
Use your eyes.
Use your eyes.
Do not forget my story, Senua. Because your darkness comes from hell, and your fate lies there. They say the burning of a corpse will take you straight to Hela's gate. But gods and the living will follow this path. You must leave the Isles of Orkney across the Eastern Sea and find a road that leads north and down through deep dark valleys. After 9 nights of riding, you will follow a great river.
The darkness is coming. It yearns for life. Hungers for it. Like a pack of wolves on a hunt. Stopping. Not this time.
Can you see it?
The land of mist and fog.
He's in there.
The old fool was right. What was it he said? The river of knives across which lies the halls of hell. Place they call Helheim.
He's lost.
Where are you? There's no doubt about
He's
it.
Lost.
The source of the darkness is in Helheim. And the goddess Hela holds his soul there. Her dear beloved, Dillian.
What is she doing? Why is she doing this? Why doesn't she turn back? She's doing this for him. She wants to rescue him.
He's already dead.
He's dead. But his soul is in Helheim. His soul still lives. She needs to save his soul.
She wants his soul to be at peace.
She needs to lay him to rest. He's already dead.
She can
can save him. There's nothing
she can do. It's a bridge to Helheim. I forget its name. She forgets too. But she does remember that only the dead may cross it. That part wasn't so easy to forget. The old fool said there was a hidden path up to it. Let's see, shall we?
The Northmen speak of 9 worlds. The world of men they call Midgard. The sky gods dwell in Asgard. The gods of earth, harvest, wind, and sea dwell in Vanaheim. The good elves dwell in Alfheim. The evil ones dwell in Svartalfheim. The mountain giants dwell in Jotunheim. The fire giants dwell in Muspelheim. Niflheim is the world of ice and darkness. Only the dead dwell in Helheim. And that is where you must travel.
Don't kill me. I'm not one of them.
Don't listen.
I was just hiding. I find I live longer that way.
Don't listen.
I'll never let the bastards catch me again. Never! Wait. Who are you?
It's just a memory.
Truth? Is that you?
My tales of the Northmen. They call me Druth. A liar. An old fool. Druth is my truth.
It's good to see you again. You kept your vow.
To guide you in this life and the next. I will tell you my stories of hell. If I may walk with you.
Tell me your stories again, old friend. I'm listening.
The runes seal the gates to hell. Focus your inner eye, and you too will see what's hidden in plain sight.
I can see one.
Hold it in your mind's eye. Find one like it to open the gate. Look towards the gate, and the gate will open.
The gate is open. Go through the gate.
Go through it.
It's dangerous.
Follow it.
What's behind? It works.
I spent 6 years enslaved in hell, but I watched the Northmen. Learned their ways.
I know you did.
You listen? When everyone else laughed. My people paid a heavy price. Carry
my stories with you. And together we will make the Northmen feel our fury.
Another voice joins us. She once tried to make them go away. Pretend they weren't real. But what good is that? When we are. The same with heights. You can stand on the edge, pretend it's going to be okay, but you know that death is near, waiting for you to make that little slip. You can't just wish things away.
She's terrible. She can do it.
The world of the dead is ruled by the giantess, Hela, daughter of Loki. The gods feared her bloodline, bad on her mother's side and yet much worse on her father's. So, as a child, the Allfather cast her down into Helheim and gave her power over those who die of sickness, age, hardship, and self-slaughter. In all of the nine worlds, only Hela can resurrect the dead. To Hela, your Dillion was sacrificed. And with her, you must bargain.
The gate to Helheim divides the living from the dead. Is that the face of Hela herself? The half-rotten goddess that rules over Helheim. Whatever horrors lie behind that door, she must find him.
Get back! This is coming!
vision of what's to come. Poor Senua. The darkness does not bargain. It does not reason. It is rot. And now it has taken hold. It will spread towards her head, the seat of the soul, until there is nothing left of her. All of her suffering will have been for nothing. It's just a matter of time. The hardest battles are fought in the mind. That is what Dillian taught her. With every defeat, the dark rot will grow and soon it will take her soul. But for now, at least, she still has control of her mind. And she will fulfill her vow. Whatever the cost.
He's not my name.
Listen to me, Senua. The goddess Hela lies behind the gate to Helheim. To open the gate, you must first face the gods that guard it. The god of fire, Surt, and the god of illusion, Valravn. Spill their blood to open the gate to Helheim and enter the land of the dead.
To Dillian,
to his soul.
The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness. Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice, and the first giant was born and was named Ymir. The ice continued to drip, and the power of the void gave life to it, and it became a car.
Valravn, ancestor of the seers and master of ravens. He hunts his prey with his powers of illusion and feasts on their remains. Follow the path to Valravn and defeat him in battle to earn his mark. The gate to Helheim cannot be opened without it.
Ymir was a frost giant, a being of darkness, and all his sons and grandsons were dark after him. Of his daughters and granddaughters, some were monstrous, but others fair. But there was another who came from the ice, Buri. In shape, he was like a man, big and powerful. His son, Bor, took a fair giant to be his wife, and they had three sons. Odin was the eldest, and the Northmen hold him to be the foremost of the gods, the All-Father. illusion hides the path to Valravn. Don't trust your eyes. Find another way to see the truth.
Funny. We all want to see behind the veil, don't we? Once we do, we mostly just close our eyes again and pretend what we saw was never really there. Once you gaze into the relentless darkness, all that lurks within it can see you too.
Just
stop her. She will find what she's looking for.
Valravn's power of illusion comes from ravens. Align the ravens to break his magic seal.
Show me what you have seen, Druth.
Look how much it's changed.
To break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravn.
passing into another world that looks the same but feels different. An imposter world where the forest itself is watching.
Another gate. You know what to do. Stay back. You have to open it. It's not safe. Don't listen to them. Listen,
to break the seal, align the ravens with the mark of Valravan.
What does it mean? Line up her ravens.
Which ravens?
Where are they?
Can't you see them? She can't see them.
Look around. Try to find the ravens.
Line up the ravens.
She journeyed into the wilds of her native land, living off berries, roots, and rabbits. It's not uncommon, you see. We call such a person a gelt. Some, like Truth, become gelt in search of penance. Others, like Senua, to purge a curse. Those who make it back are forever changed.
She can get up now. What's happening? She can get up now. How can she get out? It must be magic. Dark magic. A trick. Valravan. Tricking her. Valravan. How can she get up?
Bait.
It's him.
Dark magic draws her closer.
It's not him. He's helping her. It's not him.
It's a trick.
She's doing it on her own. He's not tricking her. It's magic.
It's an illusion.
Thank you.
And we think of a shadow in the woods. A creature in the night. If only it were that simple. The worst kind comes without warning. A deep and primal signal from within. A reminder that just because you cannot see the threat, it doesn't mean that it's not already here.
Exactly.